especially in Darwin theory, Prabhupada talks very clearly in English. It's good. Next, ours is a cooperative movement with Krishna and the advancement of Krishna's movement at the center. We must continue to sell as many books as possible, but discuss everything amongst yourselves and do it nicely without irritating anyone. That's the art. Book distribution is most important and the other is not so important, not like this. Properly respecting everybody's service. So for this we could do that all the series members say, why don't you take 10 small books, just 100 crowns and every month. We have 50 members doing that, that's 500 small books. And then we always meet somebody and you put it somewhere in the doctor office. So if you start thinking, you will open up possibilities. You never think about it, you will not see the opportunity. Right? And then if they do that service, then dynamics and the scores should be announced, there has to be talked. If something is very important, if you don't never talk much about it, how it will be important. So that is so nice. Because I'm stressing one thing, book distribution especially, does that mean that everything else is not important? No, everything must go on. That's nice. Please consult with your temple president and your DBC for direction as to what is your best engagement. Then, it is the Sankirtan which is the life and soul of our movement. Sankirtan and book distribution should go on together side by side. So a little bit more Harinam also. That's good. And on the Harinam, if you have 10 to 15 members, then we can do a lot of book distribution and so on. Like in Soho, they were doing that. And with Danish Shoku, he talked to him, he said, let him sing, he's a good singer. So I was singing 2 hours and all, so successfully. We had a group of 10. And then 2 devotees with a stack of small books and 3 guitars, and they were all gone. And that's nice. And that's good for the Buddhist also, he feels confident in the atmosphere. So that we can do the shopping streets of Copenhagen are too much beautiful. No cars, it's a whole network. It's like nectar for the Harinam people. Also, sitting is also good, walking is also good. And we should be part of the shopping center. Copenhagen center means, if you go to Copenhagen for tourism, then part you see colorful Hare Krishna there. Like Oxford, the third attractive thing is, I don't know what the first two was, but the research has done by a tourist. And what is the most attractive? And number 3 was this colorful singing on the street of Oxford. So why not in Copenhagen? If you're not too shy, if you have a little interest.
We have a lot of them. Used to walk and stand at one place. So when they, walk and then you stop. And at that time, we used to have a little talk. And then at that time, the book distributors.
Yes, slowly going. Yeah. That would be nice, huh? So that's what Prabhupada says here. The Sankirtan, which is the life and soul of our movement, Sankirtan and book distribution should go side by side. I'm always glad when these activities are increasing. And when Prabhupada is glad, we become glad. If Prabhupada is not glad, we don't become glad. That's so nice, huh? And my pleasure is always in increasing. So, Chakshu, some realization, the word is also good. I can say frankly that whatever results I am getting are coming only by the mercy of the other devotees. And because they support us and free us from having to worry about this or that problem. We can just go on with a clear mind. If I had to go out and my mind was dwelling on what's not working or what's going wrong because the devotees in the temple don't care, then I wouldn't have the power to convince people because I would not really be convinced about the beauty and the power of Krishna consciousness and how nice it is to be in the association of devotees. That's interesting. If you would go on book distribution, but if you come back and nobody cares, nobody asks any time anything, then it's not so inspiring. Right? But if you come back and all the devotees are aware, they are conscious of the different devotees, and they are very loving and always try to help, and you know why you're doing book distribution, because it mixes, it makes sense, both together, right? But because the devotees all work together, there is a dynamic spirit, both in the temple and among the book distributors. Strong cooperation makes it easy to be convincing. Strong cooperation makes it easy to be convincing. And that is what people feel when you're on the street. This guy is convinced. Nice, huh? Then Manila also, and Harikesh. This is one very famous thing I like to repeat. That was for me long time inspiration also for many years. I see my role in the book distribution mission as making sure that all the activities of the Krishna consciousness movement in all the temples are directed towards getting out as many books as possible. And making sure that all the devotees understand that this is the main goal. So now, that time was more, all the devotees were mostly living in the temple. But the same principle we can apply now. Also, now it has widened up. You have a lot of congregation, you have a lot of Indians coming. And they all have to know about how important the book distribution is. You can have some quotes also. And we have to live it, of course. This is Harikesh, a remnant. So book distribution is in the bones.
Yeah. Just like on YouTube, you know, on Facebook, you put up that video from London, Namhata. It was like just 10 devotees in one Namhata program, and old people and young, they went together just, and in 1 hour they distributed 95 books.
Yeah?
For the first time. This is not this film that you put up on Facebook site.
And you can imagine what an effect it gives on the member of the congregation who had never been on the street, but now he goes out and he's inspired. He's coming here lately, so I hope he gets some point how good Prabhupada's teaching is, because he comes here. And then he goes out and he's able to give it out. Most of the members, they never try to preach to others much. I can see. But if we help them, those who experience, to give them that experience, how dynamic your bhakti vriksha is. I have experienced one thing. It's good to tell maybe. Because I have a friend, Radesh Prabhu, who has a business in Gujarat. And for 10 years he had a Namahata of 100 members. But he had difficulties to keep them inspired. They had their weekly program and he's a very nice devotee. But he tried to keep his members inspired and like this, he did the program, this and that, sometimes out with them for 3 days. But the real spark came. Then at one time I had compiled one paper of 108 reasons why to distribute Bhakti Gaudiya magazine. Because in India they are very cheap, 10 rupees in 3 languages. It was there. It's so nice, it's easy to distribute 10 rupees and they're quite nicely designed and colorful. So I was for some time, I requested Revatmanapu that we get a Telugu version from the Bhakti Gaudiya magazine, and now we have it, and every month 40,000 copies per month.
40,000?
Yeah. And subscriptions also, all these things are helping to set up. And the Chakrabarti, it's called Chakrabarti, who coordinate all the distribution, recording how every month, how many one member makes members. On the tables also we make, not only the books, we make subscriptions for 150 rupees, and they get 12 received. And then Madhu Gopal makes the whole administration to send it out to labeling. So every month, we have 3 workers who label 20,000 addresses for sending it to post. Like this. So he read my presentation. I give in Lokanath Maharaj's own seminar on this for 2 days. And we went to all books from Nectar, because many doesn't know these books. So now, every morning in Tirupati, we read one quote in the Mahamarti. My personal book, I gave to the Vedic monk. We said, we have to start this, otherwise we don't keep that spirit high. So now so much more inspiration. So then Radesh, he started to, you, I said, you wrote, we can have 10 million copies in 5 years' time. If every member brings every month 10 subscriptions, which is quite not me to keep around a strength. And then I put all proper quotes on Back to God magazine. It says, the life and soul of our movement, it is the face of our movement. Magazine makes sense. The magazine is the face of your organization. And it has to be so designed that it is up to date, attractive for all types of people. Right? So he says, I was inspired by your presentation, and I had copies of all these reasons and copies of Prabhupada's quotes. And then he was one of these members of the seminar. He said, then I started introduced to my members, and they started to pick up that. And I got many members who started to make these PTG subscriptions. And he says, after that, my Namrata was so dynamic. Because now they know why they come to Namrata. what is that? If you start preaching, and now they have competition amongst each other, I keep a list. And he's writing the articles. He started with Gujarati one. There was no Gujarati version. So he was so inspired. He started the first with the Hindi one, but we need Gujarati. And he's compiling the magazine, and it's a strong article. You can see nice photo design and up to date, you know, relating to what's going on in society, all these things. Now, the Tamil opened up also after that. Telugu had, Gujarati opened up. Bengali, Hindi was always there. English is done by Chapati. And they have competition. So every month, I think 300,000 magazines coming in India. The logo of PTG. So that's what, yeah, like you said, getting out as many books as possible and making sure that the books understand that is the main goal. We have to bring more and more people to Krishna consciousness by giving them Prabhupada's books. To do this, we have to create an atmosphere in which book distribution is seen as very, very important work by all the members. So the more members are appreciating it, the more the Shakti increases about it. So we have to communicate. One thing is doing the service, another thing is communicating about the service. Right? And unless one is Krishna conscious, he will want to do things according to his material inclinations more than anything else. Therefore, inspiring the Buddha to go out is not easy if the atmosphere in the temples is unfavorable to Buddha distribution. If all the devotees are busily engaged according to their propensities, a potential book distributor might think, why should I struggle to distribute books? Right? So I am so impressed by those who keep going every day.
By what?
I'm very impressed by those who keep going out every day here in Denmark also. Because it's not easy to go out every day, but they're doing it. And my head off. I don't have it. Therefore, one has to create an atmosphere in which everybody can understand with his transcendental that the book distribution is the most important activity and that it is going to get the supreme results. And please sit down and bring us all back together. It is the primary purpose of the Krishna conscious movement, and Prabhupada said that enough times so that everybody can understand.
But does it then not mean that whether you are Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, or Sudra inclination, you know, like your Varna, that it doesn't matter in the sense that Prabhupada wanted every member to know the art of food distribution, right? So in that sense, I mean, Prabhupada, he was very stressing the point that we all have to be situated according to our abilities and Varna and you have to be properly situated in Varna Ashram. But Prabhupada also said that each member of our society must learn the art of distribution, so it doesn't matter whether Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra, Brahmanas.
Yeah, that's fine. A Brahmana will distribute, if he's Brahminical, we were discussing last week with Dalitana probably this point. He said, all these different inclinations. Yeah. When somebody dramatically goes on book distribution, he will maybe not be the biggest book distributor, but he's always in the mood of try to explain people and try to help the people. And Kshatriya, he will be more in the mood of buying book distribution, can conquer the world. And the Vaishnava, he will say, okay, it's so nice book distribution, but if I have a good profit of it, you know, and I can maintain myself with this. And yeah, when he's more like simple, so then he might just do it because it is supposed to be done.
That was one of the very sweet devotee. He is just in India. He is going on Harinam book distribution every day, and elderly Prabhupada disciple, Sarva Pama Prabhu. He wrote on Facebook that I became addicted to getting appreciated by the public. You know,
in India, it's so nice.
Yeah, he said that if I don't go out, then I don't get this appreciation, because one devotee was writing, we all need to be recognized, you know, as people, as
interesting point.
We all need to be appreciated for our services, you know, like have this exchange of love. And then he wrote that, I am addicted to go out and get that exchange of love with the public. I mean, it's not to say that he is a sutra, but you know, like many times we know that sutras are like film stars and, you know, like this kind of musicians that who needs appreciation a lot, yeah. More than maybe a brahmana who will just do his service, you know, whether he is appreciated or not, you know.
Very good, yeah.
But it's just sweet that, I was just thinking maybe if you one is a sutra, one will be very much concerned about getting this appreciation, but it is also fulfilled on Sankirtan.
Yeah, or someone can be, or those who you can take some books and give this gift to somebody if you cannot distribute it, or at least you give it out. And so you can do that, and then the knowledge goes out, right? Yet it is so important to preach in such a way that the devotees who do not distribute books can feel they are connected to book distribution. Our managers have to help everybody to understand this. For example, the Pujari department worships the deity and assures us of the Lord's mercy. And we aspire to please the deities and want to distribute books for their satisfaction. Therefore, at the end of the week, we read our book scores to the deities. That's nice. In Tirupati also we do that every day, still now. And the cooks are prepared for Sharam to give everybody strength and enthusiasm. Especially in December practice, all of us simply engage in Buddhist scriptures to make sure we keep up the spirit of understanding what the topmost part of preaching is. So, that was something.
No, I just have a question about what you read before, about this, that everybody should be engaged, and because some we see sometimes some devotees are really good at distributing books. You know, they are determined, they are kind and fixed up like that. But this, like we saw now in London, which is going on with the congregation, it seems to be equally important to empower others, you know, to actually get more of our congregation here in Denmark involved, you know, empower them.
In different ways, like smart boxes, we can design some things in some shops who like it, and they can, and donation box which is locked, so they can, nobody has to be there, they just have to put in 20 grand and they can take the book out of honesty, like they do with the vegetables on the side of the road. Somebody can make a few in Antwerp. One devotee, Dharani Taipu, my friend, he designed, and there is one vegetarian restaurant, and already 400 books went in the last 6 months.
How many?
400.
Wow.
Ahar, the vegetarian restaurant is called Ahar, near the Diamond Center and the office center. And he's, I saw him 5 years ago at the restaurant, and I said, no, it's booming like in it. And on the counter, our stand is on the left side, Paquitas, and on the right side, Susan. Now they want to create that problem also. So there should be.
And it is not an ISKCON restaurant, it is a vegetarian restaurant. Yeah.
But this Olga Vishnu is a very friendly man. Mm. He loves the peace.
Jai also took like 60 books for December.
Wow.
40 Danish.
And Vishal also, maybe?
Vishal, I'm not sure. Jai had taken a few times before also, no? He was like giving out.
He's good, man. Very serious. Yeah, like this, and also others, I think. The elderly congregation.
Arun had taken
something. Give it.
Arun maybe, I think, had taken something also.
It's nice. But this quote of Ajahn is, we remember that. Yeah. That's so, it's a good way of management. You could see it worked like anything. Then Manirakuru. Sometimes, now quote for Manirakuru. Sometimes management and Sankirtan seems to be like two worlds. One is here and the other is over there. I think that's a serious problem. If we want to keep our preaching spirit, we have to connect the two very strongly. Actually, managing means pushing the cause of book distribution. We are supposed to achieve good results in the field of the book distribution. Therefore, it has to be our priority. Otherwise, it will be de-emphasized. Things merge and we lose the main point, like my advisors who say that Krishna is everywhere and you don't need to go to the temple. But if Krishna is everywhere, then he is in the temple too, and actually he's especially there. Sometimes we end up saying Prabhupada gave us so many instructions, Prabhupada is everywhere. So we intimate that he is not in Sankirtan. It's an indirect, subtle thing. Because it's too heavy service. But if he is everywhere, he must be in Sankirtan too. And actually, as he said again and again, he's especially there. If someone is qualified to perform another service, he should do that. But he shouldn't declare his service as the all in all or something better than Buddhist Krishna and use that against Buddhist Krishna. That's all energy, sir.
But this point not to become proud of one service, that is, as far as I can see, the most important. Because if you become proud of being a book distributor, you lose all strength and all energy and all mercy. Mm. It is like the same in all services. If the cook becomes proud, you know, then there is just that there is no potency and you start burning everything. And if that puchari, you know, you lose your enthusiasm to just do it all the time. You know, each service has its austerities and challenges, yeah.
Okay.
But if we become, if we cannot see ourselves as a servant of the others, you know, we are all just servants of the servant of the servant, yeah.
Yeah, or a temple president or a good preacher, we get proud. We get proud. Or the temple president, he gets in the power idea, or a good preacher, he gets too much self-conscious and get in trouble.
This is why the highest positions always say that they are the servants of the others, yeah. Like the guru will always consider himself the servant of his disciples, yeah. Facilitating them, like he will see them as being sent by Prabhupada. Yes. So also in our services, like always see ourselves as a team, like a machine.
Yeah,
each part is important too. Like if we are very thankful that everyone else are doing their services, like we are thankful to somebody, you know, that he is going taking care for Nitai so that we have time to go out. Yeah.
That really
he's facilitating, we are all facilitating each other that we can go out.
And it connects everything. See this? Harmonious dynamic connections system, that has to be very important.
Then we empower each other, to do our respective services.
Like Harajana, who is so nice, he picks so many breads.
The Harajana.
Yeah, for us, and he wants to have anything you need. And
he must get as much mercy than the book distributors just by serving them. Mm.
You want to say something? Put on your finger.
That was this. You said in the beginning that there was this with the politicians, that the politicians have to take 50% of the karma.
Yeah.
I heard it's just like they take taxes and it's like 1/6, like around 20% of the karma they get, like 15%, you know, like that is 1/6. You have reference? Yeah, we need reference.
Yeah. Actually, enough to go to hell.
Yeah, I mean, once, it's of so many people.
But if they just know that, how they will start acting differently, much more energetic to make it natural. So, we can have so much of us, I realize it.
If they support us, then they also get our, because whatever good we are doing, then they also get some credit. But that, if they support the temple and if they...
In London it's happening.
Yeah. Okay, now time is up.
Yeah.
Okay. Jaya Srinivasa.
Jaya.
Jaya.